Hi everybody, my name is Olivia Gudaniec and you're watching Olivia Reviews. This is the very first video out of a series from the Béis Travel line. Today we're starting with the Weekender Bag in beige, as you can see. I think this is the second generation because it doesn't have the glossy, shiny finish. It does have the matte, which I personally love 100 times more. So this bag is priced at $98 US. I read in a bunch of comments that the prices have actually gone up since the official launch, so we're almost at the 1 year mark since the launch. So this is a second generation bag, and I believe that there is a third generation coming with the bottom half being able to fully detach. But we're not there yet, so let's just review this bag and everything about it. So we've got the logo here, and at the very front, we've got a zipper pocket. Then we've got the straps that are apparently not supposed to kill your back. This bag is huge. I don't really think you can not kill your back with it, but you guys can let me know in the comments below. This is for the trolley slash your luggage. So the handle, it can easily slip through. I love the opening more than anything because of the open wire. It is to die for. So we've got the laptop pouch. It comes with an extra strappy handle. So if you don't wanna wear these handles on your shoulder, you've got this option, I guess. We've got another zipper here. We've got two little compartments. And I'm gonna give you guys a tip. If you buy the back seat organizer from Béis, which I just happen to have because I'm extra, and I also review this in another video, so stay tuned and watch this entire playlist. You can literally use it for more storage. So if you want any more tips and tricks on that, just keep on watching. So that's pretty much it for the top part. Everything shipped to me really quickly from Béis.com. I ordered on Sunday. I am in Canada, and it came to me on Wednesday through DHL shipping. So it's very, very easy. You just have to be home, otherwise I guess it delays your shipment. All right, so we'll just get rid of that. So the interior is supposed to be water resistant. I'm gonna give you my spiel on water resistant versus waterproof. They're completely different. Yes, water resistant will resist the water, but not for too long. So please, if you love this bag as much as I do, still take care of it. I don't anticipate on having anything leak, so I'm gonna just bag everything anyways. The bottom half, people usually say is for shoes, inside clothes, anything you need. It is a much larger bag than I originally imagined. I'm petite, I'm 5'3", so this kind of overpowers my body. There you go. It probably is the size of my body. And I also wanna say, I definitely, because this is fabric, I sprayed this with the Scotsgard fabric protector just to repel rain, any spillage on the outside, and of course, try to prevent any dirt from accumulating. I typically spray all of my fabrics, whether it's a backpack, purse, chairs that I have in my kitchen. So that has been something I've been doing for a long time, and it doesn't harm any other part of the bag. So if you do have a chance to grab one, any kind of a spray protector works just fine. Oh, forgot to mention this little, these little rings, which is, I guess, for your travel wallet, which I also purchased and made a video on, so feel free to check that out. I'm not gonna cover what the material is because I think there's a bit of controversy whether it's vegan, I don't know, the website doesn't say it, so I'm not gonna give you any information I'm not sure about. If you guys have any questions about this bag, let me know. My main thing was that they are mainly advertising this as a bestseller with the carry-on. Personally, I did not understand how you can have this and a carry-on on a flight. Like, you can't have two carry-ons. And to me, this is just as big as a carry-on. So I reached out to a bunch of you guys, and many of you say that this you used the Weekender, the Béis Weekender, as your personal item. A personal bag to me is more like a purse slash backpack. Even with my backpack, I've been stopped at a few airports to make it fit within the wired frame. If you want to get technical, I would research the airline you're about to get on to find out the exact measurements of a carry-on of your personal item, because this is definitely too big, but I think it's really just the discretion of whoever is helping you. Apparently, a lot of you just travel with this as your personal item and your carry-on and you're fine. If that was the case, I would be more than happy and I would do that, but instead, I actually bought the bigger 29-inch Béis hard side luggage, because if I'm going to have a risk of having to check in a bag or not, I'd rather pack in as much stuff as I can, if you know what I mean. So that's why I bought that. If you want to see the review on the Béis luggage, the bigger one. I did reach out to Béis to try to get you guys a discount code. Didn't work out this time, but hey, if you don't ask, the answer is always no. So I did ask and I'll continue to ask. So hopefully if you keep watching these videos, one of them will have a discount code for you to apply on your next Béis purchase. If you wanna know why I'm doing these videos, I do a lot of traveling. I try to go on like two bigger trips throughout the year and then a few little ones sprinkled throughout. So definitely check out my travel videos if you haven't already. Thanks for watching, everybody.